Well, we're here with Dr. Adami from Delray Beach. How are you, Dr. Adami?
I'm doing just great, Helmut. How about yourself?
Wonderful. So, Dr. Adami, tell me, there's lots of people out there who, you know, they have missing teeth in their back. One, two, maybe several. Either way, they have them missing for quite a while sometimes, like years.
Mm-hmm.
And
sure.
Nothing really bad is happening, so at least we people think. And yet you dentists keep telling us you got to replace those missing teeth, otherwise all hell breaks loose. Can you shed some light on that?
I certainly can. Yeah, what can tend to happen if you're missing teeth for a long period of time is your bite just collapses down. You lose all the support.
Bite?
Well, the way your teeth come together, the distance between your teeth decreases, and your chin comes up higher and higher, and your face looks shorter. It can cause wrinkling to your cheeks. It makes it difficult to chew. It can also cause problems with the jaw joint. Over time, you can get some tenderness and some problems with the joint itself.
Wow. So what you're saying is here is, I mean, this is wrinkling. So basically you're telling me that, you know, like some of those old people, they have missing teeth, they may have dentures, so that their bones, their arches are kind of like shrinking. And that's how you kind of like start looking like a dried out tomato.
Like a dried out tomato is a very good analogy. You tend to look like a person much older than what you really are.
We don't want to look older. So it's not So it's not only about digesting, which is probably an important thing to do. Well, like I know my wife, she keeps telling me, you know, because I sit down, and she has barely had her first bite down. I'm done. You know, I don't seem to be chewing. So obviously that there's that aspect. But to most of us, that doesn't ring true because we might not chew with or without teeth. But looking older because you get a fallen in face, now that rings true. Now, and the second thing you said is getting tension. So makes sense to me, coming from an engineering background, that when you have hinges and they're used uneven, that all of a sudden one or the other hinge is kind of getting out wacko and all kinds of stuff happens and you get a torque on it. And so that's when you get like maybe a little stiff neck, even lower down, maybe headaches.
You can get headaches as well. Sure, that's very common. What can also happen too is because you haven't got teeth in the back, you wind up biting only on your front teeth. And you wear the stuffing out of those front teeth and you wind up beating the heck out of those teeth. And those teeth become very worn out and they can break and fall out much sooner than they would if they had some help with the back teeth in place.
Well, I guess you did shed some light on this question, and and it's really, I didn't expect, it's quite amazing to find out that, oh my God, you get a fallen in face, I mean, and maybe even headaches. So some people who maybe have gone to a chiropractor or otherwise taken aspirins by the truckloads, and it doesn't go away, would it be wise for them to kind of include a dentist into their check up and mention to the dentist about the headaches and stuff like that so that he can see whether there's something uneven, even though maybe all the teeth are in it?
That is absolutely the fact. There was a very strong connection between unexplained headaches, tension neck aches, and how your teeth come together and how many teeth you have and how even the bite is. It makes a tremendous difference. And it should be explored as one of the options to headaches.
Doesn't hurt.
No, not at all.
That's a new one, huh? Going to a dentist, it doesn't hurt, huh?
The examination never does, no.
Well, all right. Well, thanks a lot, Dr. Adami. I'll speak to you more about other topics. Bye-bye.
You're very welcome. Bye now.